What do we understand? Each one of us has a different, we have a different image, we have a different meaning in our mind. So even if one or two can tell me, you can unmute, what is personality according to you?
It's behavior.
Yes, behavior. One by one.
Behavior of a person.
The behavior of the person. Okay, that's of course certainly important. What is?
Personality is the sum total of all behavior.
Pardon?
Personality is the sum total of all behavior, attitude, knowledge. Okay. It includes all things.
Okay, that's nice. I'm happy that you're giving me these overall, broader prospects of personality. Because at times, sometimes we also think, in that personality is maybe looks and the way we just, how we behave in front of others. No, it is a bundle of many things, as rightly said by you, that it is a bundle of your attitude, your behavior, your thoughts. In fact, in short, I would say it is like a perfume, your overall, wherever you go, it goes with you. So you understand, if we have a beautiful, perfume, so everybody is attracted. And everybody, even if a 5-10 interaction with a 5-10 minutes interaction with such a person, we feel, wow, like it was so good, interacting with such a person. So that's how we need to develop ourselves. And when we talk of personality, of course, there are various domains. That is why this program has been planned in such a way that right from understanding yourself, your strengths, your weaknesses, isn't it? Then your goal setting, your communication skills, all these will be taken up one by one. But today, to begin with, I feel personality, when we need to develop, if we have to develop our personality, as we said earlier also in my inauguration, that this is something which starts from childhood, isn't it? Personality development is something which starts from childhood, then in our school, it keeps on adding. But then there is always scope to enhance our personality. We already have good personalities, isn't it? But there is always scope that we can add something here and there, and we can enhance it. We can make it better and better and better. Okay? So with this basic understanding we go. Now, when we talk of personality, I said different aspects we will be covering during this training program, all related to one another also. Today, we will be mainly focusing today morning on two important life skills, which are stress management and conflict management. Okay, they are very important. And if we are able to manage stress, we are able to manage conflicts well, we can resolve conflicts, then you understand how much difference it will make to our personality, isn't it? It will make a difference to our personal effectiveness. So today my session today, first one, I'm going to start on stress management, and then after a 5 minutes break, maybe in between, we will complete then conflict management. Okay, coming to stress. Now, what is stress? Again, I want answers from you. You can unmute. What image comes to your mind, or what comes to your mind, whatever, in whatever form, when you hear the word stress? Yes.
Pressure of a specific situation.
Pardon?
Pressure of a specific situation.
Okay. Yes. Others?
Ma'am.
Yes.
Stress is a feeling of emotional and physical tension.
Okay. We can say, some people have emotional tension. Yes. 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 Tell me.
Insecure feeling, ma'am.
Okay. Feeling of insecurity.
Insecure feeling, ma'am.
Okay.
Yes. Hello, ma'am.
Yes.
Ma'am, uncomfortable feeling of mind. We can say.
Okay.
Confusion.
Confusion against any situation.
Yes. These are all part. Some of them are symptoms of stress. Yes. Yes. But of course, they are part of stress. Anything else? Yes. There are 40 of us, here. I want at least 2 more responses. Please.
Restless state of mind.
Okay. Yes. Now the boys also. I'm seeing only the girls responding. What about some boys? Yes.
Hello.
Yes, tell me.
Ma'am, it's just a feeling of emotional or physical tension.
Okay. Physical and emotional tension. Yes.
It is a result of a challenge or a demand situation.
A result of
challenge or demand situation.
Okay, when we find something challenging.
Challenge, yeah,
and
it
okay.
gives us stress.
Okay. Maybe something which is beyond our coping, isn't it? We are not able to cope with it. Okay. That's right.
Ma'am, any situation causing uneasiness to human emotions.
Okay, uneasiness to human emotions. Okay, thank you all. Now what I gather,
Hello?
Yes, please continue. Yes, complete.
Ma'am, it's result of frustration or anger.
Frustration and anger.
Something.
Okay, so with stress, yes, anger and stress are related. We'll come to anger management later on when we deal with conflict management. Yes, you are sure. I mean, that is there. Okay.
Ma'am, it is a pressure that is unmanageable.
Yes, it is a pressure which is unmanageable, or we can say it is a pressure which we feel it is beyond our coping, isn't it? If we are not able to cope with it. Yes, excellent. This is, I mean, I got good responses from all of you. And so now with this understanding, now, of course, we all know, as we say, stress, you know, it's the disease of the millennium, you say. It's an invisible disease also, we can say. And it is affecting, you can say, from, in fact, some people say from womb till tomb. Isn't it? Till we die is going to be there. But then I will come later to on to it, that not all stress is bad. Okay, some amount of stress is good also. But the fact is, it is inevitable. It is there in our lives from the beginning to the end. So if it is there, and it is going to be there, isn't it, throughout our life, so what we have to do? We have to understand why this stress, firstly. So our first portion, part of our presentation will be on understanding stress. And secondly is, okay, if stress is there, it's going to be there, how do we manage it? Clear? Okay. So now coming to understanding stress, of course, definitions and all, I will not get into detail here. We all have an idea of what stress is, but let me start with an example. I mean, let us again, let it be interactive. Let us go back to the cave age, you know, the jungle. Jungles were there, the caves were there. So in the jungle, there were animals, there was a tiger also, there were lions also, isn't it? So imagine that all of us are going back to that age. We are in the jungle and we see a tiger in front of us. So what do we do? Now your responses, what do we do? We are there in that cave age and in the jungle, and that there's a tiger in front of us.
Suddenly we step.
Yes?
Ma'am, we can either run or fight with that tiger.
Okay, yes. So two options are there. So either we can fight, which of course is very difficult, and running away from the tiger is also difficult, but we just have these two options. Okay, so what is this called? Either the fight or the flight. Now let us, of course, the cave age is not there, the tigers are no longer there, the jungles are no longer there. We wish, of course, we had more forests and all jungles, but they're no longer. Maybe the real tiger is not there. The tiger has changed its forms. But what happens, you know, if, you know, we have to be ready to fight the tiger, whether we have to run away or we have to fight, isn't it? So what do we, our body prepares us, you know, this body is very intelligent. It's, you know, like it prepares us to fight or to run away. You understand? That is why if you realize, I mean, you go back, all of us have gone through stress. So what happens to us when we are under stress? Now, can you tell me some of the symptoms? There's short-term stress we are talking about. There's long-term stress also. What happens to us when we are under stress? That means the brain, you know, starts with the brain. The brain has somewhere sensed that, yes, the tiger is there. Now the tiger can take other forms. It can, isn't it? It can be a boss. It can be a colleague. It can be a situation. It can be anything. Okay. Now the brain has perceived it and it gives a signal and your body starts preparing to fight, either to run or to fight. So what symptoms do we get? Now, one by one, all of us, not all of us will get all the symptoms, isn't it? Yes, some of us will get some symptoms, some of us will get other symptoms. Yes, can you tell? Now, the others who have not, replied so far. Yes. Yes, what type of symptoms are there?
Either physical or emotional.
Body shivering.
Let us talk about the physical first. Yes, as you are very right.
Body shivering is there.
Body shivering is there. Yes.
Sweating.
Yes, ma'am.
Sweating.
Then what else?
Sweating. Lack of energy. Sweating. Lack of
sweating. Sweating.
Okay. What else?
Nervousness.
Nervousness. Okay. Does the throat dry at times? We feel the throat is drying.
Yeah.
Focus is on only one
more. What else?
Fatigue.
Okay.
Migraine or a headache.
Okay. Yes. Later on, we can have migraine and headaches also. Now, if you, why I'm asking you this question is that I come back to is if you know, as I said, you know, our body is preparing us, isn't it? It is preparing us. So, you need more energy to run or to fight. So suddenly you'll feel there's a spurt of, you know, you feel more energetic. Isn't it? Your eyes, you know, dilate. You can literally see better. You can hear better. But in order to, you know, make your body ready for this, some of your, you know, other systems, they need to be temporarily, you can say, closed in the sense like the digestion. Isn't it? It's not needed for any emergency. So what happens? Okay. You know, that can stop. You know, that process can stop for some time because it's preparing. Understand? Now, what are the symptoms? So, you may need to, you know, make yourself light. You may need to go to the washroom because your body is preparing you to run or to fight. So, you can get, you know, something in your stomach. You can get, you know, that feeling there. Your throat can become dry. Then, what else?
Yes.
Yes. Your heart, isn't it? What happens to your heart?
BP is increasing, ma'am. Heartbeats are increased.
Heartbeat is also increasing, isn't it?
Yes, ma'am. Okay. Yes, ma'am.
So, like, there are a number of symptoms. Now, it, literally, you know, it says even, you know, your body is so intelligent, you know, your capillaries also, you know, like, the body prepares you in such a way so that in case there's a cut also while fighting or by fleeing, running away, that minimum blood loss is there. So what I mean to say in short, there are a lot of, you know, chemicals secreted in your body, but the hormonal changes are there because it is preparing you. Yes. Now, if you have to really fight, it's all right. Or you have to really run, it's all right. It's preparing you in the short run. But supposing this happens again and again and again, you think of something because it starts with the brain. It has, you know, perceived that, yes, there's a tiger in another form, and it starts preparing you. It's doing its work. This has not changed over the years. So many years, isn't it? This the body functioning is not changing. So it is keeping on preparing you. But the fact is now that we are neither fighting nor are we running. So what happens? All these, you know, chemicals and hormonal changes, they are happening. You cannot stop them. And you can, if you're sensitive, you please listen to your body. You feel it also that, yes, I feel these changes in my body. So if over the time, you know, if this keeps on happening very frequently, isn't it? And for a long time, then all this accumulates in our body. You understand? Because it's not being used. So it accumulates in our body. And unless, you know, of course, we are physically very active, which normally these days, you know, we have, yes, we are sitting on the table, we have a laptop, we have our phones, we have a desktop. So not so much of physical exercise is there. So like you can say, in short, like, you know, like toxins, it is accumulating in the body. You understand? So this will happen whenever you perceive something stressful. And this is how then they say though stress directly does not lead to diseases. But yes, indirectly, it now many research studies are there which says, you know, that even if there's a existing, you know, a disease which is, you know, maybe, you know, it is not in to a greater level, but then it can get aggravated. There can be, you know, frequently you feel cough and cold, more energy, more, you know, allergies, more headache. You know, your immunity tends to go down. all these other effects. So understanding this is very important. Now, if this is happening to our body, we need to listen to our body. We need to know what are the symptoms. Like somebody said, of course, there are symptoms, physical symptoms are also there. And then there also, it affects your body, it affects your mind, it affects your emotions. And in the long term, it affects your behavior also. Can you make out people or who are under stress, or you yourself also when you're stressed? You can feel these changes. Maybe people around you also comment, kya baat hai, what is happening? You seem to be under stress. People also comment. It is visible. So we have to take care of this. And that is why then stress management is the next part, which is important. Now, initially, I would like to say that, you know, there is nothing like a magic wand. And there's no one size which fits all, that we say, okay, these are the techniques. And you apply this and the stress is gone. No. The stress, of course, either we can, if we can, at times we can, you know, escape that situation which is causing stress, but that's not always possible. Or we can, you know, eliminate the intensity of those stressors, what is causing stress. Or we can adjust ourselves. Or we can, you know, enhance our coping abilities, what we call resilience. That is why we have to develop resilience, coping abilities, that whenever stress is there, we need to develop our coping abilities. As long as we feel, you know, okay, something has happened and you understand this is normal, this is going to happen. But if it is there, then you have to change your perspective. How serious is it? How much, you know, in the long run it is going to affect me? How much time and energy am I putting into this? Am I getting some negative worries, unnecessarily anxiety, unnecessarily worries? Then you need to put a stop there and then, okay? Because you have, there's, you know, something which I would say, you know, when we have understood what stress is. Now, let me tell you, there's an ABC theory of stress. ABC, in the sense, you say, there's some activating event. There is a stress. Something is causing stress. Now, again, the stressor will be different for me. It will be different for you. And we have to identify what causes our stress. What are those stressors, you know, which trigger that stress symptoms in us? This is an individual exercise. I want you all to note down, and then maybe later on I'll come back to you. What happens to you when you're under stress? Isn't it? Your body, your mind, maybe somebody's irritable, gets angry easily, some have headaches, some have migraines, some have stomach upset. You make a list for yourself. Because then accordingly, you will make your stress management plan also. Then you identify, do this exercise, maybe the last 1 year, any one or two stressful situations you pick up, what was that triggered that stress? What was that trigger? What was that cause? What happened to you? How did you react to it? And in future, if such a situation happens, can you change the way you reacted to it? All right. Now, coming back to this ABC model, while I'm saying here is that A is an activating event or a stressor. Something happens in the environment, but the fact is the C is for the consequences. The consequences can be positive for stress. They can be negative also. But what decides that the consequences are going to be positive or negative is the B in between. And B is our belief system, which I say belief system, but it is the individual with his belief system, with his perceptions, with his attitude. Understand? So it is not that something has happened, there's a stressor, there's an acting event, and directly there's a consequence. We are in between. How have we evaluated that stressful situation? What appraisal have we done? What is our attitude towards it? Do we feel powerless, or do we feel, no, this is under our control, I can cope with it, I can manage with it? So you understand? This B, that means me and you, we are very important players in managing our stress. stress management depends a lot on us. Let us not be slave to stress. In fact, we have to be masters, isn't it? Masters to check it, masters to control it, not fall prey to it. Let us not be slave to this stress. And so much depends on us. So much depends on us. You think it depends on us? Something yes. happens, maybe in your college, I can say college, classroom, your hostel, your environment, even at home. You see, the event is the same, the activating event, the stressor, but then all people are not reacting to it to the same way. Do you agree with that?
Yeah, ma'am.
Some people are able to manage yes. it very well. Some people yes. sail through it very smoothly. And some people also break under that stress. So yes, the stressors are there. They are, you know, life-changing events are there. Something happens, there's an accident in the family, or, you know, there's a death in the family, there's a loss of job, or even a new job. All these things will be there. But then, but we in between are very important to manage our stress. Am I clear so far? Now ask me any questions, please. Then we'll come back to the next. Please ask me. Yes, please feel free. Okay, I want the session to be interactive. Feel free.
What are the positive stressors?
Yes, okay, very good. Excellent question you have asked. Now I want to come back to this, that yes, as I said in the beginning, all stress is not bad. There is something like good stress also, your stress, and there is negative or distress also, which has negative consequences for us. For example, you know, our exams are coming. If you didn't have a little bit of stress about our exams, do you think we would study so hard? We would put in so much energy, so much effort? Would we be so alert? No. And as you see the examination day, you know, it comes, it's approaching faster. You become more, you know, energetic, more, you know, attentive. You can concentrate more also, your concentration. So that is positive stress. Even in, you know, if you have a job, if there is something challenging, a challenging assignment comes, you become scientists, you become professors, whatever profession you go, you can become entrepreneurs also. So if there is some challenge there, a little bit of stress is there, that is good. That raises your performance, that raises your productivity. But yes, after some time, then there is, you know, after some time, if it continues and continues and continues, then there is a problem. So then it becomes negative stress. And now let me explain this with an example. Like in school, we all of us, you know, we had physics also we studied. We know if we have a curled string, you know, wire, okay? Or let us put it like this, and you add some weight to it, okay? If you add some weight, what will happen to the string wire? It will become straight?
Yes. Up and down motion.
Okay, then you remove it, you remove the weight, it curls back to its position. It curls back?
Yes, ma'am.
You add some more weight, again you remove the weight, then again it curls back.
Original position.
Yeah, original shape. Okay, but a stage will come if there is too much load, there is too much stress. What will happen? Even if you remove, try to remove the stress, it will go out of shape. Agree? It will become straight. So this is with us, you know. A little amount of stress, okay. Today we had some challenging assignment, you know. You had to prepare some term paper, some seminar, something you had to do. It gave you a little bit of stress, but you worked hard for it. And next morning, again, you're full of energy. You go back to college and you're very happy about it, and you're happy to change another challenge. That is all right. You have slept overnight and it is fine. But then if it is too much and you keep on carrying it, then of course, as we say, we can reach the stage of burnout, what we call in organizations, or breakdown also, nervous breakdown also. So it is along a continuum. I'm very happy you asked this question. So let us, little bit stress, I said, is okay, but let it not go up to that level where, you know, we change, our behavior changes, you know, our productivity goes down, we become moody, we have frequent, you know, illnesses, and we are feeling, you know, our immunity also goes down. No. Please do not let that stage come. Be careful. Understand that, yes, what is happening to you, what is causing you stress, and feel this is normal. This is okay. Stress is going to be there in life, as I told you, from the beginning to the end. But yes, tell yourself that I told you A, B, B, you are in between. I can manage it. It is under my control. I can cope with it. I can do something about it. And it's not something which is going to last forever. This too will get over. Okay. That is important. Now, one thing I want you to do, maybe like wherever you are sitting, if you have something, anything around you, it can be your maybe notebook, or it can be a glass of water, or whatever it is, please lift it up. Lift it up like this. You can see me? Lift it up. Lift it up. Yes, very good. Keep on lifting. Yes. Now you will not put down your hands till I tell you. Okay? A little higher also, maybe if you can take it. You're lifting it. Yes. Yeah, now, supposing something happens, you know, I get an urgent call from, you know, my director or somebody, and I have to leave this session. But then I forget to give you this instruction that you put it down. So you keep on carrying. And I come back after the meeting and I realize, my God, like obedient students, you know, you all are students. You have been listening to it and you've been carrying it. So what will happen? Just now nothing is happening. But if you carry it for a few hours, what will happen? What will happen?
It will start paining, ma'am.
You will get pain, isn't it? It will be difficult for you to carry it. So if you carry the stress, you keep on carrying, you understand? But what I tell you now, keep it down. Yes, all of you, keep it down. I can see some of you, yes. So do you want to carry your stress forever? Do you want to carry that load? It's not that stress is, not, I mean, that is, you know, you understand? It's how long you carry it. That makes a difference. So immediately you have to tell yourself, it's time, you know, stop. That's called the, you know, your thought process, you know, stopping immediately. Give a signal to your mind. Even if you can, you know, say loudly, capital STOP, I have to stop here. Stop it. I have to bring down this stress. I have to leave it. Little bit worry, little bit anxiety, no issue. You know, but they say our worries and anxieties, let them not sit in your head for too long. Like supposing they are birds, you know, let them not make a nest over your head. No, don't allow that. Because once, you know, that happens, it sinks in. And the deeper it sinks in, the more difficult it is to come out of it. We have to let go, what we say. We have to let go. Very important, in capitals, L-E-T, capital G-O. Let it go. Let it go. So even if you remember this and you remind yourself, okay, I think I'm carrying it. Sometimes, you know, even ages we are carrying something. What is the point? It's not serving anything. Maybe we are angry also. Somebody talked of anger, you know, anger management, that itself. Maybe later on a conflict, we can see how much time we have. But, you know, like Lord Buddha said, you know, anger is something like, you know, it's a burning coal. You're carrying it in your fist, okay? And you're angry with somebody. When the right time comes, maybe I will throw that coal on that person or, you know. But do you realize it is burning your hand? You realize it's burning your hand?
Yeah.
Don't carry that anger, please. And anger, like stress, conflict, they're all triggering. It disturbs your body. It disturbs your mind. It disturbs your emotions. Okay, all these reactions will happen in your body. And if it is, again, long, it will have, like I told you, it will have its own, you know, negative consequences. That is when stress becomes negative. So far, okay? Now, any questions, please ask. Yes. Please, your questions, please, I'm waiting.
How to avoid stress?
How to avoid the stress? Okay. See, certain everything cannot be avoided in life. For example, let me tell you, there's a famous, you know, Rahe's scale was there. There, you know, these are life events, you know, like which have happened maybe in the last 1 year, 2 year. For example, you know, death of a partner. It causes obviously a lot of stress, some accident in the family, or, you know, like even, you know, having children. Now I'll come to it later. You ask me how that will become stressful. It's a positive thing. But if certain events happen, you know, life-changing events are happening, then certain adjustments are required. And the fact is, we cannot avoid it. Like, for example, marriage also, we say, okay, marriage, having children, they're wonderful things, isn't it? Most of you are not married. In future, you will get married. But at the same time, it changes things for you. So you're not going to avoid it. It's not that you're going to not, ladies are not going to have children, or you're not going to get married, or you're not going to have a new job. Even changing a job, that will give some amount of stress. But then understand positive as well as negative situations change, they are likely to give stress. But then see what you're going to get out of it. Motherhood, the most joyful experience, isn't it? Nothing like the joy you get from your children in life. It's the biggest gift from God when you have children. But yes, when ladies, we have children, it brings stress also with us. It changes our routine. If you are working ladies, there's double burden. You have to manage the home, you have to manage the office, you have to manage the baby also. But then it's a bundle of joy. So not to be avoided. Am I clear? Have I answered your question?
Yes.
Certain situations, yes. Certain people also, if we can avoid, if we can go away from that situation, but that is practically, you know, not possible always. You're in a college or you're in a job. Supposing you're in a job like agriculture universities or ICR institutes, permanent jobs. So you're going to stay in your office for years together. You can't leave that office. You're not going to leave that office. Very difficult to get a job once you become, isn't it? So you have to learn to either eliminate that stressor, or you change your perspective towards that situation. You improve your coping abilities. You improve your resilience. Now, what is resilience? Let me explain before you answer. Something like, you know, you have a rubber ball. You keep on hitting it. It keeps on bouncing back. So when we have resilience, maybe there will be stressful situations, something which will, you know, there can be shocking situations also, we fall down, but then we again bounce back. That ability we need to have in us. We need to build that resilience. Okay, something has happened, but we bounce back to life again. We are full of energy. We are full of hope. We are full of positive thoughts again. Understand? That resilience, you see a small baby. Okay, let me give you an example. You have seen babies when they start walking. Have you seen them? Huh?
Yes.
You have a small baby in the family. Then you see, my God, it's so difficult when they take their first step. They will fall down. But then again, they walk. Again, but does a baby think, oh ho, main gir gaya, I have fallen down. How should I get up again? Should I get up again? Or should I remain in that position only? So they fall and they get up. They fall and they get up. Isn't it? And they fall so many times. And then, of course, the whole life, they are walking around. That is the type of resilience we have to build. Yes, now questions, please. Yes, somebody was asking some question.
Hello, ma'am.
Yes, tell me.
अगर इंसान की लाइफ में हमेशा मतलब उसका लक अच्छा ना हो हमेशा हेलो
हाँ आपका ऑडियो इतना साफ नहीं आ रहा है बोलिए चाहे हिंदी में बोलिए इंग्लिश में बोलिए
मैम मतलब दो तरह के पर्सन होते हैं एक की लाइफ में हमेशा सक्सेसफुल आते जाता रहता है और एक की लाइफ में हमेशा मतलब बैड लक रहता है कि उसमें उसको ये नहीं मिला तो ऐसे टाइम में क्या करना चाहिए
ओके दैट्स आल्सो अगेन अ गुड क्वेश्चन Of course, as I said, you know, like there are different aspects which are causing, you know, changes can be there in the life, you know, sickness, as I said, death and all those things. Besides that, personality types are also there. And another important thing to answer your question is, there is something like, I say, a concept which is called locus of control. Okay, now to explain in very brief, since you have asked this question and it is important also. Control is like, you know, how much do we feel powerless, or do we feel this is our life, I am the master of my life, and whatever, you know, what is happening in my life, my achievements, my failures, they are due to myself. Or do we feel, you know, it's the external world, it is the powerful others, or it is destiny, Bhagwan ne hamari किस्मत ही ऐसी बनाई है, ये तो होना ही है. सो इसमें क्या है, हमने लोकस कहाँ बना दिया, एक एक्सटर्नल को दे दिया. तो उस केस में हम क्या करेंगे, जहां हमने where we have thought, you know, it is something external, isn't it external, others or destiny, or it is, you know, like, then we feel we cannot do anything about it. But if we feel it is internal, yes, I am responsible for my life, I am responsible for developing my personality, I am responsible for my success. And when I say success, success does not mean always only money and positions, but yes, to be a winner in life, to be happy in life. And when I feel I am responsible, I will do something about it, I will be proactive. Now, to give again, like, it's a concept, but since you have asked, it takes a long time, exercises itself. Let me start with an example. Let me explain with an example. I have two sons. Okay, now both of them, supposing, are going to college. So the elder one, you know, he comes and I ask him, and the younger one is in school maybe. So I say, you know, okay, how was your exam? So one of my, you know, the elder one says, ki mummy, mama, you know, like the teachers, you know, whatever, even if I try very hard, you know, I'm not going to get good grades. Hana? So wo to question paper out of syllabus tha, then it was this, like this, it was like this. And the teacher is also, you know, not, she doesn't like me, she's favoring a few students. So I said, what do you expect? Result of aisa hi aana hai. Then now ask my younger son also. He's also appeared for the exam. Beta, kaisa hua? How did you do in your exam? As parents, we are always asking these questions. So he says, ki nahi mummy, exam to theek tha, but frankly speaking, I could not do well. And I am responsible for it. I think too much of smartphone and, you know, too much of cricket. And I was playing too much. And I really didn't put in that much effort. So you understand, the younger one has an internal locus of control, the other one has an external locus of control. So, like, maybe there's a short exercise. Let me see, sometime during the training, if there is time, we will do this also, where you can identify for yourself also whether this locus of control is internal for you or external to you. It's along, again, along a continuum. Okay, how strongly internal, how strongly external, or in between. That, so this is important. Have I answered your question? That, and you know, this improves your coping abilities. Always remember that ABC model. If B, I am in between, if I feel no, I am responsible for my happiness, I am responsible for developing my personality. And remember, all have a choice. We have choices in life. It is my choice which path I have chosen. It is my choice I'm doing this. It is my choice I want to be happy. It is my choice I want to be successful. I can choose otherwise also. And life is wonderful. It gives you a lot of opportunities. It gives you a lot of choices. But who has to make that choice? Tell me, who has to make that choice? We have to make that choice. We have to make that choice. Remember, between a stimulus and a reaction, some space in between. Something happens, there can be immediate reaction, or we can utilize that space in between. That space is always there. And instead of reacting, we respond to that. That means we make a deliberate choice. Okay, this is what has happened. You understand the situation, you appraise the situation, these are the consequences it may have. But then I have a choice. Instead of reacting like this, I will respond to it like this. Even a small break, if you give for some time to yourself, the reaction becomes a response. Clear? Even the small habit, if you develop, that whenever there is something, there's a trigger, there's a stressor, instead of immediately reacting, give some time, give some space, even if it's a short one, and then take a decision what you're going to do, how you're going to cope up with it. Okay? As human beings, you know what happens? It's a tendency we will react. Because, you know, our emotional brain reacts first. Then the logical brain takes over. So if we give it a little space, then we logically think about it. Then we go ahead. So has your question been answered? What's yes. your good name?
My name is Alka Singh.
So have I been able to answer your question?
Yes, ma'am.
So when we say, you know, some people are successful in life and some, whatever they do, they are unsuccessful in life. It depends on us also. Okay? Let us not think, you know, like success is for all of us. You are going to be successful. Believe me. But then you have to believe in yourself. Will you believe in yourself? That yes, I will be responsible. I will be successful. I can be successful. Keep yourself motivated for it. Have clear-cut goals in life. And not only having goals, follow those goals. Nobody can stop you. As Swami Vivekananda has said, you know, others have also said, we as human beings, especially you young people, you know, wonderful girls and boys, you know, you have so much potential. There is so much power within you. But then you have to bring that power outside. You have to recognize that power within you. Then only you will bring it out. Okay, like somebody has said, there's a quote that don't think you are a drop in the ocean. No, you're the ocean. Okay, you're the ocean. You're not just a drop there. You're the ocean in that drop. That's their potential. You can be successful. Okay, I hope in future, please keep that in mind. Certainly, you are no different from those who have been successful. Not at all. In fact, we all are very gifted. We need to be grateful to God, you know, that, you know, you've got opportunity to study. You come to college, isn't it? You have, you know, your hands, your body in good shape, good health. You all are young. Health is on your side. Everything is there. What else do we need? Health is wealth. Okay? Certainly. Then it's just your thinking. It's your attitude. And it's the choices which you make, which is going to make you successful. Now, since this is a very important aspect, I'll take some more time. I'll give you a story I will tell you. Just a small one. You must have read also in your childhood. Like once, you know, a man, he found a eagle's egg. Isn't it? It was in a nest somewhere. And what he did, you know, he put that egg with the hen's eggs. So when, you know, the chicks came out, so it started behaving like the chicks around. It won't fly very high. It would flutter like them only. It would behave like them only. One day, that, of course, but it was an eagle. One day, you know, it saw a beautiful eagle flying in the sky. And he said, my God, what a majestic bird. It is so wonderful. It's flying so high. It's so elegant. It is so majestic. But then he didn't know that he himself was that eagle. Isn't it? Have I made my point? Okay. Thank you. Thank you for the nice question you asked. So you all are eagles. Isn't it? You're going to fly high and high and high. Isn't it? And like, it's not that, as I told you, personality, we already have good personalities. We will keep on improving. And especially, we will make changes in our attitudes. You know? Having a positive attitude, that is important. Okay, any other question? Then I move ahead. Let me have a look at the time also, because we have your other topic also on conflict management. So what I'll do is now, Now we will come to maybe understanding this stress, you know, and different stressors. Now you have to identify what is causing you stress. They can be external factors also. They can be internal factors also. Internal has to got to do with us. Okay. So if they are external factors and they are internal factors, you make a stress log, you make a stress diary. Accordingly, you will have your stress management plan. And also you list down the symptoms which you are experiencing so that what you need to do in order to take care of your health. Because ultimately, health is wealth. Do you agree with that? Huh? You people are young, so we at times young, you know, youngsters, they take health for granted. Because it's given to us. God has given us good health, so we take it for granted. The fact is, health is wealth. So कहते हैं ना हम लोग कहते हैं स्वस्थ काया सुख सुख यही है स्वस्थ काया प्रथम सुख इट इज अ फैक्ट एंड व्हेन वी टॉक ऑफ हेल्थ हेल्थ मींस इट इज फिजिकल इट इज इमोशनल इट इज मेंटल इट इज ओवर सोशल सोशल ऑल दिस इट्स योर फिजिकल मेंटल इमोशनल वेलबींग ऑल दिस Huh? So take this, it's, you know, all these different dimensions are important when we talk about having a good health. And that is possible when we take care of our stress, we are able to manage our conflicts. Then, of course, it is one of the factors. There are many other factors also, your lifestyle and others, which will take care of good health. Okay. Now, with this, now let me come to the stress management part. Now, stress management, as we have seen, you know, like, again, since we talked about that ABC model, so I would say there is, you know, we can say these are the cognitive methods, we can say, to do, got to do with our attitude, with our thinking, with our mind, isn't it? Developing our sense of control or sense of coping. So these cognitive techniques are important. Along with it, even physical techniques are there. They are also important because the stress is affecting the mind as well as the body and the emotions. So all these are important. Now coming to the first one, we have seen stress affects us physically and in the long run, it has been, you know, it can, you know, lead to a number of diseases also. So if it is affecting us physically, what can we do? What can we do? How do we take care of our physical health?
By exercise and lifestyle management.
Exercising.
Yes, exercise. Very good. Lifestyle changes. Yes.
Very meditation. Good.
Meditation. Excellent. See, some of you, as I said, have symptoms. Some of us have more of, you know, symptoms related to the mind. You know? Their meditation is very important. Some of us have physical. So physical exercise, both are important. You have to maintain a balance. But then meditation is also important along with your physical exercise. Now coming to the physical exercises, you can choose whatever you want. Like I said, you know, when you're under stress, there are triggers. Your body will experience all these stress symptoms, isn't it? There will be certain, you know, hormones and chemical changes in your body, which in the long run may not be good for you. Similarly, the good side of it is, if we, you know, like do physical exercises, maybe walk for 1 hour or 45 minutes also at a stretch, then our body releases good hormones also, like serotonin, isn't it? Endorphins, the feel good hormones. If you go for a long walk and you come back and you feel suddenly, I mean, nothing has happened, but still you're feeling very good because your body reacts that way. So you get that feeling that I'm feeling good. Physical exercise can do wonders to your body. It is walking or it is yoga. Whatever suits you, whatever you like, you can do as you want, isn't it? There are a number of exercises, but walking and yoga, definitely. I have tried it myself. And yoga, you have to experience it. It is so wonderful, you know. It can really do wonders to your body as well as to your mind. So, and don't think yoga is, you know, just a combination of very difficult asanas and all. Even simple ones you can do. Okay, start with just simple ones and then move ahead. And of course, walking. You can do walking. Any problem in walking? No walk. No. No resources are required. No special kit is required. Or at least that can be done. Previously, you know, we were moving around. But now, if you see, I mean, you, if you, even if you count the steps, you feel, my God, from morning till the evening, I have hardly, you know, moved around. You can barely count the steps you have taken on your fingertips. Is that normal? Is that good for your body? Our body is not supposed to be sitting for hours. No, certainly not. Continuous sitting can do a lot of harm to us, to our body. Yes, we have jobs, but let us take some breaks in between. Like this, cigarette is bad, they say. These days, they say sitting is the next, you know, next to the cigarette, doing so much harm to you. If you continuously sit, it's not good for your eyes also. Take a break. You're staring continuously at the screen after half an hour. Go and have a glass of water. Small things, don't keep the glass of water just next to you. Keep it somewhere away. So at least you will walk. Walk there, get a glass of water. It'll make a difference. Now, just now also, I want all of you to get up from your seat. Get up, put your hands like this. I don't know where you all are. And if you can a little bit jump, do that. Yes, do that. Do that. Get up. Leave your seat. Leave your seat. Yes, excellent. You can do a little bit of jogging. You can jump wherever you are. Some physical exercise. And remember to smile while you're doing this. Okay. Smile sends a signal to your body. All is well. Okay, your body and your emotions are related also. What you think, what you do will affect your body, isn't it? And now move around a little bit, jump around just for 2 minutes, not more than that. Okay, otherwise Dr. Barman will tell me, ma'am, what is happening? Session is going to end. Okay, good. Now come back and sit. Come back and sit. Sit down. How do you feel? How do you feel now? A little better? Yes? Are you smiling? Remember to smile. Smiling and laughing are very important. They can do wonders to your body. Again, there's research on this also. You know, when you're laughing, it tunes up your whole body. Okay? And when you smile, why not smile? It's a new day. Huh? It gives signal. Everything is okay. And smiling is easy. All of us can smile. We don't need any resources to do that. Okay. So this is one thing. Physical exercise is very, very important. Second thing is breathing. Okay. Of course, all of us are breathing day in and out. But then, how are we breathing? Is it the proper way? Have you ever thought how babies breathe? And gradually, as we grow up, how we change our breathing pattern? Again, a very short exercise. All of you, put your hands on your tummy. Put your hands, sit straight. Your back should be straight. And put your hands on your tummy. Okay? Yes? Put your hands on your, and your back is straight. Now you will inhale. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Hold your breath. 1, 2, 3, 4. Then exhale. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Do this for a little while, just few seconds, okay? Please start, all of you. Take deep breaths. Smiling also. No tax on smiling. Okay. Now, be comfortable. Now, tell me, was your hand moving up and down when you were breathing? Satya batana. Okay. Honestly. Adeen also said honesty is very important. Huh? Was it moving up and down? Or little bit? Very little bit or not at all? Very little. See, but ideally what should happen when we inhale, we are taking in air, we are taking in oxygen, isn't it? So our stomach should come out and then when we exhale, it should go in. But then we are not doing that. If we are not doing that, what will happen? We are not taking sufficient oxygen. We will feel tired very soon. We will feel fatigue, isn't it? And your brain will also not function well. You need water also. You need oxygen also. Everything you need for your body to function. You need proper diet also for your body to function. So somewhere, you know, even if for a few minutes you can do proper breathing, that is important. It makes so much difference. It sounds like a very simple thing. But practice it, it will make a lot of difference. Even when, as we say, some of you said initially, when we are under stress, our mind is confused. So if you do some deep breathing, just concentrate on your breath, you will see you will start getting clarity. You will start getting clarity. Okay, so try this. These are small tips I can give you in this short time. I wish we get in future, you know, more time and maybe, you know, like, let us see. Then we can go into detail. You can, of course, you can note down my phone number and email and get in touch with me otherwise also. Now we have limited time, so in a limited way. Then another thing is, you know, nap. What is a nap?
Sleep.
Short sleep. How short? Approximately?
10 minutes, ma'am.
Okay. Now, when you have hectic schedules, your exams are coming, or otherwise also you're in, I mean, when you have, you know, your office job and all, then these naps in between, isn't it? Maybe lunchtime or whatever it is, just a short nap, 10 minutes, 15 minutes. This nap is called power nap. Again, there's research on that. You know, I won't go into that, but it can do wonders to your body. It can do wonders to your body. Because when you're taking a short nap, jisko kehte hain ki jhapki si aa jati hai, samajh gaye? Aata hai na, you just, you know, you're about to fall. There's a lot of, you know, positive changes in your body. Your mind, like you have your desktop, you have your laptop, you have so many files, you know, here and there. So during this time, your body gets time, in your mind, you have number of files, you know, number of information data, all that gets settled down. And when you get up, just after that, you feel fresh. You feel your mind is also clear. You were not able to take a decision. Maybe now you can take a better decisions. Now you can see things from a different perspective, from a different light. Okay? New creative ideas will come to you. But this short break in between is important. That is why, you know, in European countries, especially in Germany, in fact, some of the students in Stuttgart, you know, they have developed this, you know, sort of a small couch, you know, which they can fold and take. And now, you know, they take money also. They charge a few euros in UK, where, you know, people go very busy in their office from morning till evening. They go there, have a short nap and come back. That is the importance of this nap. So this you can do. Can you do this easily? Simple technique. Simple to do. Okay. Now the next, of course, laughing we said. You can laugh loudly. You have to laugh heartily. Will you laugh? Yes. How many of you just laugh? Laugh, okay. Khul ke haso. Okay, how many times you will do it? At least once in a day. At least once in a day. That is very important. As I told you, it will do wonders to your body. It is very important. You have seen elderly walking in the park, hana? Unke laughter clubs hote hain, haste rehte hain. Ye nahi socho ki wo kya hai, aise hi bade log hain, budde log hain. They got nothing better to do. But it is important to laugh. Okay? It is important to be happy, important to smile, important to laugh. All this will take care of your stress also. Okay. Then another thing, sleep. Sleep is important. Yes?
Very, very.
Because I see, I mean, including my own sons and children, I see my nieces, nephews. Aajkal bachche na bahut late tak jage rehte hain. They sleep very late. Then they get up also late. So they don't. It is important, you know, that you fix your sleep timings. Sleep is very important for your body as well as for your mind. Like I told you, the powerful nap. The sleep is also very important. you must have, you know, like it depends, again, their individual differences, you know, 7 to 8 hours or at least 6 to 7 hours, that much sleep is essential. It sorts out things. You will feel much better. You will feel energized. If the mind, you know, if you are sleep deprived, then again, you're bound to have more stress. We can easily do that. Mushkil hai sona? Tell me, is it difficult?
No, ma'am. No. Very easy.
No.
Yes.
If time allows.
Ha, but of course, time will allow. Kya karna hai 24 ghante mein batao? You don't have the time.
7 to 8 hours sleep.
Who doesn't have time to sleep? Tell me. Now, who doesn't have time to sleep?
I have.
That is why we have kept a session on time management, okay? There's one session on time management. And my dear young friends, remember, time is 24 hours for all of us.
Yeah.
Hmm?
Yeah.
We have to manage ourselves. Understand? Yeah. Rest will be taught to you. We have to learn to prioritize. If you will prioritize what is important for you, sleep is important for you, then definitely you will take out time for sleep. You have to manage yourself. Okay. Please, you young people, don't tell me you don't have time to sleep. Just now you're not even working. All right.
Yeah, engaged in mobile surfing.
Yes, mobile. See, mobile, then they will tell you time management. That is, you know, it is, why do we need to spend so much time on the mobile? Agar mobile se switch off ho jayenge to kya hoga? Eh? Koi pareshani aafat nahi hogi. So switch off the mobile for some time. Yes, maybe we are spending too much time on mobile, you're a fact. So there is, now you see, you prepare the whole day, how much time I'm spending on what? A time log, along with your stress log. Now from where can I take out time for my exercise, for proper sleep, for a proper lifestyle? Time to see 24 hours se nikalna hai na. So you have to adjust your time. And if you want to, you will certainly do it. Nobody can stop you. Hmm? So remember, sleep, very important. Don't deprive yourself of sleep, please. It is not good for health. Not good for health. Hmm? Like diet is also important, a nutritious diet, where you have fruits also, vegetables also. It's a balanced diet. It's a diverse diet, isn't it? All colors are also important. All cereals, pulses, fruits, all types are also important. So you have to, diet and exercise and sleep, they all go together. All are important. I can't go into the details of all. And another thing which I would like to say is, you know, relaxation. You, what comes to your mind, there is something like, you know, in yoga also it's taught how to relax. There's something like total relaxation. And those of you who have been practicing yoga or even, you know, maybe reading something about it, can you tell me? Yes? Anyone of you?
At the last moment, we will do some nidra, like that.
Shavasana. It's called a shavasana, like a yes, corpse. Ma'am. Anna, like a corpse.
Yes, yes, ma'am.
So you can do it yourself also.
Yes, shavasana.
So it's a technique you can learn. You can ask anybody, isn't it? It's an online class, so I will not be able to teach you that. But if we learn to relax, you know, go into deep relaxation, that also does wonders for you, your mind, your body. Because, you know, your brain, you know, it changes the state of your brain waves. It slows down your brain waves. Alpha waves are there. That is the time, you know, when your mind becomes so creative, so relaxed. And in fact, you know, like you can feel the difference when you come out of it. And even 10 minutes of relaxation is sufficient. It can do wonders. Do learn how to do it. Okay? We have to learn how to relax. Okay? Anything else? Meditation. Again, meditation is not always, you know, going to some, you know, very lonely place, sitting there for hours and hours. Even a few minutes, you have to still your mind. You have to, do you need to still your mind?
No.
Okay, let me ask you a question then. most of the time your mind is having some thoughts. Yes, one thought or the other is flashing through. Are you always thinking of something positive, something good? और कुछ ऐसी भी चीजें हैं जो मतलब इतनी पॉजिटिव नेगेटिव भी हो सकती हैं और मे बी यू नो नॉट रिक्वायर्ड आल्सो अननेसेसरी वरी
आप ही है मन में
होता है ना नहीं होता है उस सबकी हमें जरूरत नहीं है वी डोंट हैव टू थिंक सो मच ओके गिव सम रेस्ट टू इट स्टिल योर माइंड फॉर सम टाइम एंड हियर लेट मी टेल यू वन थिंग Now again, the time is short, so just important points I am touching. There is something like internal dialogue. There's a dialogue within ourselves. हम लोग कुछ अपने आप से भी बात करते हैं कभी?
Yes, ma'am.
Thoughts हैं, विचार हैं, है ना? Again, if you see the nature of this dialogue, most of the time it is negative. होता है ना? Unnecessarily worry, unnecessarily anxiety. And we are worrying about things which will not happen also. 90% of the time they don't happen also. But today we are worrying about it. Hmm? It happens?
Yes.
So who can change this internal dialogue?
We.
Ourselves.
Yes,
you are in control of that. Change it into a positive. Analyze that again in your stress diary. Right? Most of the time, what are the thoughts which are coming to me? What is the dialogue going on within me? What am I thinking? Why am I thinking so much about it? Why am I worrying so much about it? Analyze your internal dialogue. And then, as I told you, you are the master. You're the master of your life. You're the master of your stress. Change that dialogue into a positive one and see the difference. Your negative is not going to be doing any good. Is it doing any good?
No.
Okay. Now here I want to give you the next tip on stress management. That is all when these, you know, as we say, it's an internal, it's a negative, maybe not always positive, little, you know, but so this internal dialogue we can change. And early in the morning, if we get up and we say some positive affirmations, you can note this word down, positive affirmations. Anybody has heard about these? Can you tell me? What are positive affirmations?
I'm going to saying ourselves to that I'm going to complete all the tasks I have planned today.
Yes.
And it is going to be a good day.
Yes.
Saying such positive things to ourselves.
To us. Yes. Very good.
Making a good sentences.
Yes.
To
and
ourselves.
It is not only saying, it is believing in it also.
Yes, ma'am.
Even if you have little bit, okay, COVID is there, Corona is there, maybe little bit, you know, some throat, then you say, no, I'm feeling good. I'm feeling healthy. I'm feeling energetic. Today, the day is going to be good. I have a presentation today. It's going to be excellent.
Yes, ma'am.
And believe in it. So start your day with positive affirmations. That again, research has shown makes a lot of difference to us. Okay, to our personality, to our confidence. And as you said, positive attracts positive. The law of attraction. If you think positive, you have positive affirmations and you believe in it also. Then you visualize it. You imagine good things. Be hopeful, like our dean said. Be hopeful in life. Be optimistic. Be positive. Good things will start happening to you. Positive will start attracting the positive. And this you can try. Try it for a week. Try it for a month. Get back to me and tell me how you feel about it. It's a small tip. It's a small technique, but it has very profound effects on you. Now, as I said, you know, like we cannot go into too much detail at this point of time, but we have a conscious mind and we have a subconscious mind. Yes, you agree?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah.
Now, the subconscious mind is a very strong part of us.
Yes, ma'am.
At times we ignore it. And just the 10% or so, you know, that we are, you know, concentrating just on the conscious mind. Yes, that is important. But then the subconscious, it is like an iceberg. Titanic movie dekhi thi na, isn't it?
Ha, ma'am.
What happened? The iceberg, just a little portion is above the sea.
which is visible.
Yes, ma'am.
And the rest is below the sea. Aise subconscious hai hamara. We are not able to realize, we are not able to see, but that is what moves us in life. Our emotions, our creativity, so many things are stored there. So if I take an analogy, it's like an elephant, the subconscious. And the conscious is like maybe like a small rider on it, or maybe like an ant also, some people say. So ant can try very hard to move in the positive direction, but if the subconscious is pulling it in the other direction, what will happen? It's not going to make any effect.
Yes.
So this relaxation, these affirmations, these are very important. They go deep down into your subconscious. Okay. And then you can literally see the wonders. You can feel the wonders happening. So you will do positive affirmations. Now I'll ask you at the end of the session, what is your action plan? What all immediately you will implement? Some things you can immediately do from tomorrow, from today itself. And what you will do in the next 1 month at least. So keep on noting down. So we have, when we talked of stress management, we have talked about relaxation. We talked about nap. We talk about sleep, we talked about good diet and nutrition, then we talked about yoga, laughing, meditation. Okay? Now, coming to your lifestyle changes. So these will also lead to changes in your lifestyle. Now, you are the best judge. What is my lifestyle at present? How can I change it? How can I change it? You have to give in more time. I said time is 24 hours, but you have to give in more time to positive things, to meditation, to sleep, to exercise, to positive affirmations. You have to take time out of it. Okay? You have to bring about, all of us need to bring about changes in our present lifestyle. But you know best what is your lifestyle and where you can change it for the better. This only you can do. And it is important. If you feel it is important, you will do something about it. As long as you feel it's not so important, theek hai, lifestyle, kehte rehte hain, then it's not going to happen. So you feel it is important, then you do something about it. Okay? And of course, when we talk about cognitive, it is again, thinking, mentally making us strong. Yes, I am in charge of my happiness. I'm going to be happy in life, I've decided. I'm going to be successful in life. I'm going to develop my skills in this area. Okay, I know I have skills here. All of us have different talents and different skills. But here there is scope. I can build up more. I can attend some training program. Isn't it? And I want to do that also. And I'm going to, this is again at the cognitive level. I have some coping skills. But then here again, I'm going to increase my coping skills. Next time when such a stressful situation happens, I will cope with it better. Because you will believe here that yes, I have coping skills. I'm in control of this situation. I can manage this situation. Understand? I will have a positive attitude. Positive attitude is very important. Maybe in the coming sessions, in details, you will learn about it. But here I will just mention like this because, they say, 10% of, something is happening in life. But what happens is in life is not because of that, activating event or that stressor. Maybe just 10% because of that. 90% is how we reacted to it. What was our attitude? 90% is responsible for that, my dear friends. Always remember that. Always remember that. And that 90% can be taken care of by you. So we will finish our stress management session here. We'll take a short break, maybe 5 minutes, then come back for conflict management. Any one of you would like to summarize understanding stress, the stressors, the symptoms? Yes? More from you? What all? Any points which are you have, come to your mind and you want to, in short, yes?
Ma'am, hum jab kuch hope karte hai, us time jab apna wo kaam nahi hota, हम बहुत डिसअपॉइंट हो जाते हैं मैम. हाँ, तो हम जब होप्स लेके चलते हैं, पॉजिटिव होप्स, और वो काम नहीं हुआ तो हम बहुत ही डिसअपॉइंट होते हैं मैम. इसलिए होप्स करना ही थोड़ा सा ये होता है, दिक्कत होती है जब.
डिसअपॉइंटमेंट है, नॉर्मल है, एक्सपेक्टेशंस है, हम काम भी करते हैं, वी पुट इन अ लॉट ऑफ एफर्ट आल्सो, एंड इट्स नॉट ऑलवेज वी विल गेट अप टू व्हाट वी एक्सपेक्टेड, है ना. बट देन डिसअपॉइंटमेंट को कैरी नहीं करना है. ठीक है, थोड़ी देर को लगा, बुरा लगा, डिसअपॉइंट हुए, एज आई टोल्ड यू डोंट कैरी इट. फिर भी तो मौका मिलेगा, यंग बच्चे हो, है ना, इतनी लाइफ है आगे, इससे बेटर मौका मिलेगा, इससे बेटर चांस मिलेगी, है ना. लर्न फ्रॉम दिस, मे बी अगर कुछ हुआ तो देखो इसको मैं, ये मैं क्यों नहीं कर पाया, क्यों नहीं कर पाई, व्हाई आई कुडंट अचीव दिस, मे बी आई कुड हैव डन लिटिल बेटर इन दिस एंड दिस एरिया, नेवर माइंड नेक्स्ट टाइम. ठीक है, डिसअपॉइंटमेंट को अपना पार्ट नहीं बनाना. डिसअपॉइंट होके फिर क्या होगा, फिर हम भी डिसअपॉइंटेड रहेंगे, उदास रहेंगे, है ना. तो यू हैव टू टेक केयर ऑफ दैट. यस, एनीथिंग एल्स? यस, ओके देन. Maybe questions again, later on you can put. Hana? So we summarize with, like today we have understood what is stress, hana? What it does to our body, to our mind, to our emotional health. So by understanding this, we also know what are the symptoms, how we are affected by it, what are the stressors, what are the causes. And we also have understood the ABC model, how we can play a very big role in managing the stress. And we have learned some of the stress management techniques. Of course, there are a number of them, and it's a very, you know, like it takes a lot of time, these sessions, but in a short while, some of the techniques we have learned. Okay, so far okay?
Thank you, ma'am.
Yes.
Thank you. So we come back again just after 5 minutes, and then we will do stress conflict management.
Okay, ma'am.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Roam about, have a glass of water, kuch bhi karo thoda, hai na? Come back after 5 minutes fresh for the next session. I want you to be fresh and
okay.